Production support for award-winning News 6 has come from the Northwest Ohio Educational Technology Foundation and this public television station.
Hi! We're the 6th grade class from St. Gerard School, home of the Jerrys. Welcome to News 6!
This week on News 6, we'll hear about a program that's helping kids just say no. We'll visit a place that teaches people about the nature and the world around them. And we'll take a step into the past at Lima's McDonald House.
Hi, I'm Mike Dew from St. Gerard School in Lima. Welcome to News 6. With today's first story, here's Jenny Mustaine.
St. Gerard School has become involved in a program that gives kids of all ages an alternative to drug use. It's called DARE, and Mike Sigerson talked to Officer Mike DeVita about it.
The DARE program is trying to stomp out and prevent the use of drugs by kids of today. With the help of Lima's Police Department, saying no is getting easier all the time.
What does DARE stand for and what is it all about?
Mike, DARE stands for Drug Abuse Resistance Education, and it involves combining the resources of the school, the parents, and the police in a combined effort to help, well, kids your age, educate them about alcohol and drug abuse. Some of the activities that we have the kids become involved in are role playing, and the reason for that is because the lesson plan, the 17-week lesson plan, was written by educators with proven teaching techniques, and from that they've learned that a person such as myself just can't come in and lecture and lecture and lecture and lecture about the effects of alcohol and drug abuse. It has to be more than that. You have to have student participation through role-playing skits, through workbook exercises.
How have students reacted to the program?
At first, most of the students were pretty much standoffish from me, because here you have a policeman that they may have had a positive or negative experience with before, not that particular policeman, but any policeman for that matter. After that, after they realized that I was here to present a lesson plan to them, to talk with them, not at them, time after time, and then they begin to realize, well, maybe he isn't here just to arrest us, or maybe he isn't here just a lecture to us. Maybe he is trying to tell us something. Then they begin to warm up to me. So I've seen more and more kids beginning to open up, you know, with the types of problems that they're facing in regards to alcohol and drug abuse as a result of being in the school and being in a different role as opposed to an enforcer or a threatening a role that they're accustomed to.
This week's News 6 is being produced by the 6th grade class from St. Gerard in Lima. Lima is located about 30 miles southwest of Findlay. It was founded in 1831 and has a population of about 48,000.
The Woodhaven Program Center allows the people of Lima to get back to nature. News 6 visited the center, and Jenny Mansfield has this story.
With its many interesting programs and residents, Woodhaven has become a landmark in Lima and all of Northwest Ohio.
What's the purpose of the Woodhaven Program Center?
Woodhaven Program Center is owned and operated by Appleseed Ridge Girl Scout Council, and it's one of their three camps for girls to use during the summer and year-round. We also offer environmental education programs here for school groups. At Woodhaven, we offer natural history programs for school groups, everything from preschool children all the way up through sixth grade up into senior high. We also offer programs for adults. The programs are basically bird study, mammals, reptiles, amphibians, stars, pond study, aquatics. The children are taken out on the trails on hikes, and we also show them wild animals. At our nature center, we have hawks and owls, we have snakes, we also have turtles, salamanders, bats, and different small mammals. In the wild, on the 60 acres, deer, raccoon, and a possum live here. Raptors are birds of prey, hawks and owls, and a lot of times they get injured. Sometimes they're shot, sometimes they're hit by a car, and it's illegal for any one person to own them or take care of them. So anyone who finds an injured raptor can give us a call. We'll bring them into our center, take care of them, fix them up, and then hopefully release them to the wild. If they can't be released to the wild, then they remain the rest of their lives here as a program center bird, and we take them into classrooms and let the kids learn all about them.
What does Woodhaven do for the people of Lima?
The Woodhaven Program Center is Lima's best kept secret. It's basically a haven for wildlife and also for people that they can come out here and enjoy the out of doors, relax, and learn a little bit about nature.
Kids View takes to the street today to find out what St. George's sixth graders like best about Lima. Here's Matt Tierney.
Hi, I'm Matt Tierney, here to ask the Kids View question, what do you like best about Lima? How about you, sir?
I like the mall and the food stores.
How about you, ma'am?
I like the Civic Center where they hold great concerts.
And how about you?
I like the Ohio Theater because of the great dances.
And I'm Matt Tierney, reporting for News 6.
Not many places can give us a realistic look at what it was like to live in the past. The McDonald House in Lima is such a place, and Greg Peters has the story.
The McDonald House offers a unique look into America's past. With its beautiful architecture and interesting collections, it brings history to life for Lima.
What sort of history has the house seen?
Well, the McDonald House was built actually by Frank Banta in 1893. It was constructed when Lima was an oil town. There were a lot of very wealthy people here, a lot of money coming in, and this area was known as the Golden Block. It consisted of large mansions, three-storied homes, such as we have here. And the houses were built for entertaining, for a lot of company, and they saw a very elegant lifestyle. Inside the home, you can see it's very elegantly furnished. The decorations throughout the home are authentic to the time period. The house itself is in its original condition. It's never been restored. It consists of hand-carved woodwork, cherry, mahogany, and oak, parquet floors, beautifully detailed mantels, scrollwork, ornate columns, beam ceilings. There are special rooms, the parlors, dining room, formal dining room, and a breakfast room, trophy room. Originally was the men's billiard room. It was a room designed for men only. They could play billiards in there, they could have their after-dinner drinks, and they could smoke. Now it is used as a trophy room to display a collection of animals from Mr. McDonald. There are big game trophies from Africa, Alaska, Canada, and British Guiana, things that he shot on various safaris, including a full-mounted polar bear, two moose heads, lions, bears, variety of smaller animals. In one corner of the room there is a collection of albino animals from J.E. Grosjean. It's a one-of-a-kind cabinet displaying albino and natural colored animals that was built in 1901.
Why is it important to have a preserved house like this open for the public?
To have a house like the McDonald House open to the public allows people to come through and see a way of life that's gone for now. People just can't live, do not live like this. This was a much more relaxed time, a much slower, friendlier time of life.
That's all for this week. Join us next time when News 6 travels to Kenton, Ohio.
Production support for award-winning News 6 has come from the Northwest Ohio Educational Technology Foundation and this public television station.